Hi, this is Martina Wing, live from Hawaii, talking about manta rays again. This is my true love, and I live here on the Kona Coast. I'm with the manta rays for almost 20 years, and I love to share every Wednesday at 11 o'clock my knowledge about the manta rays. Today we're going to tie it into with other rays together, with stingrays and also little eagle rays. But my goal is to, that you fall in love with the manta rays more and more, and like I did so many years ago, and you just know about the creature and can educate people about it. And my friend Tara is back. Thank you, Tara. You're every week you're here. I appreciate this a lot. Thank you so much for that. Anyway, I'm going to put this away. I think I'm just going to fly around here the whole time in front of the camera. And then I want to go into today's subject matter, which is talking about manta rays and stingrays, and I've also bring in the eagle rays. And this is a really common question we get when people come to the experience at night and they're like, oh my God, I don't want to, what is it about the stingray and Steve Irwin and all this? We're not swimming with stingrays, we swim with manta rays. And so let's dive right into it, what the big comparison is. So first of all, species, well, they do belong into the same group of fish. It's the rays. They belong to the sharks, skates, and rays. They're all cousins to each other. And so there's a commonality. But for example, the manta ray has only two species. It's the Manta birostris and the Manta alfredi. And that's the one we see here on the coastline, the Manta alfredi. It's the reef manta. On a stingray, you actually have over 100 different kind of stingrays. So two versus 100, that's quite a big difference. On the eagle rays, we actually only have the spotted eagle rays here on the coastline, and that's I've seen over the years quite often. Not so much on a night experience, that's more like an accident, but we see them during the day quite frequently. Then let's talk about sizes. A grown-up reef manta here that we see is about 14 feet. That would be our Big Bertha. I cannot even show you how big that is, but Big Bertha is huge, 14 feet. A grown-up stingray is actually only 6 feet. So a grown-up man is 6 feet, so that would be a grown-up stingray. And that is in comparison to a manta ray. Only a manta ray would be a teenager, a juvenile manta ray with 6 feet. And eagle rays, I've never seen one bigger than 5-6 feet, so that's about it for the eagle rays. Alrighty, and then that was sizes. And then I want to now flip the camera because I always have something to show you. And so you see the comparison of the fish itself, so it all makes more sense when I talk about stuff. So let me push the button here real quick. Here we go. Alrighty. And I'm showing you a picture. Jim took this picture a few years ago. And so this is a manta ray. Yeah, so clearly this is clearly a manta ray. And then I want to show you how a stingray, and I'm looking at the underside right now, that would be like a stingray, looks very different, and that would be an eagle ray. Now, I do have another picture set up so you can see the comparison again. So this would be the manta ray. This would be the southern stingray, a stingray, and this would be a spotted eagle ray. So I think it's pretty clear they all look very different when you see them right beside each other. But of course, it's not so easy when you just dive into this world of rays. All right, so for the manta ray, I want to show you where the eyes sit. The eye sits right here on the side. And then they also have their mouth in the front. So these are the two things I want to point out. Eyes on the side, mouth is in the front. What do we do with the stingray? Stingray has its mouth underneath, and now the eyes are actually on the top, right here. And then the last thing for the, let me take the eagle ray. Eagle ray has the eyes on the side and also the mouth on the bottom. Let's get the other picture over here too, on the eagle ray. You know, the eyes are on the side right here, and the mouth would be underneath. So this is, I hope this makes sense in the comparison if you see the pictures right beside each other. So a really big difference between manta rays and stingrays and also the eagle rays is the defense. Manta rays have, the defense is size. They just swim away. When you're a 14-foot manta ray, you can swim really fast. Like think of a big bird that swims away really fast. Another thing with the stingray, if they need to protect themselves, they have actually a stinger, and it's located here in the back. And this was what the Steve Irwin died of. He was wrestling with a stingray, and the stinger just apparently got him right in the heart, and it was pretty much over. So a stingray has a stinger, manta ray has no stinger, no teeth, no barb. Stingray has a stinger, and the eagle ray has a barb actually here on the back, right here in the back. So this was the defense mechanism. So, and then I wanted to look at diet. Well, manta rays feed on plankton, so that's all they eat. It's a small critters floating in the ocean that cannot swim against the current. A stingray feeds on stuff on the bottom because its mouth is on the bottom, and it just finds food that's underneath that it can suck in with its mouth. And so it's a bottom feeder. And the eagle ray, the same. They are feeding on the bottom as well. So so that's for diet. And what else? Motion. Motion is kind of cool because I have videos prepared for that. If you want to see how manta ray is going to start swimming, coming towards the camera here in a second. Think of really like manta rays are like birds. They just have these huge wings, and it goes up and down. And I tried to figure out a word in English how to describe that. I just call them bird-like, the wings going up and down. Yes, they can turn on a dime, so that's pretty cool. This is, by the way, our Vicky Ray, one of our biggest females. Yeah, and just one more time, I want to show you how she comes towards the camera, and both wings are just going, can go simultaneously up and down. Alrighty, so this is for motion, how they move. And then let me show you the other video I have. Now that's a stingray, and that is the coolest thing ever. See, I've never seen a stingray in my life, but Ryan, my longtime assistant Ryan, she got one on the night dive, and it was in February 2008, so that's pretty cool. Do you see how the stingray just moves its fins, I guess? Totally different. I would say maybe an undulating or wavy. Michelle suggested to say la ola, you know, it's like a wave. And so the movement is definitely different. Of course, they can turn on a dime as well. See, turn right there. But the actual propulsion, the motion is different. Very cool. Yeah, and then I do have some footage of a eagle ray. And then you can say, oh, see the comparison. This was really cool where an eagle ray came in the night dive, swam through the campfire situation. And this is very similar to the manta ray, just like wings, and it's like a bird motion. Now this little eagle ray here was kind of confused. It was just really cool footage. Anyway, so yeah. So manta rays move like birds, eagle rays very similar too, and Hawaiian stingray, I'm going to go back to that footage because it's so cool. Got this so many years ago, and I actually forgot about it until Ryan reminded me of that, this stingray. We've seen it, never seen it again. It's the Hawaiian stingray. It's super rare. It's only seen in 100 plus feet usually, and I don't dive that deep. I only go to 40 feet usually because there's more color and it's just prettier and on the reef. Yeah, it's super rare to see this stingray on a night dive. Isn't that cool footage? I love this. Alrighty, enough for that. Yeah, so this was the comparison so with how they move forward. And I do want to mention that now manta rays are creatures of perpetual motion. They never lay down. They never stop swimming. They always keep moving forward. And if you would... That's kind of cool. Eyes going there. And the manta ray is always moving forward. It cannot lay down and stop swimming, like what the stingray can do. The eagle ray the same. It's always moving forward too. But the stingray is the one that actually can lay down in the sand and bury itself. And Pacific Rim Divers, one of our dive companies here in town, they got this really, really cool video recently, 4 months ago. And I want to share that with you. Because it gives you an idea how well camouflaged stingrays are actually can be. So just enjoy this. This is really cool. I love this. I'm going to give you this one more time on my back. See here are the eyes. And if you just swim around, you just don't just see the sand. And here we go. Yeah. So that's definitely good camouflaging. I'm going to switch back to me, because I think I gave you quite a few examples what the difference is between a stingray and a manta ray, and added the eagle ray to it too. And I hope you enjoy this all together. I'm going to check my list real quick if I covered everything I wanted to talk about. But yeah, I think so. So I hope if you come to Kona and you want to enjoy the manta rays here on the Kona coast, you do know that manta rays are harmless creatures, no stinger, no teeth, no barb compared to the other rays. The manta rays are big, there's no question about it, but I think this is one of the most beautiful things you can do in your life, and see manta rays in the natural environment. And what we add here to this whole mix, of course, is the night experience with the lights and bubbles and fishies in between. So I hope one day you can join us. I think I have many followers too that have done it before. So if you guys want to chime in and say how your manta ray experience went and how much the manta rays touched your heart, and that would be great. So give me a like, give me a share, give me a thumbs up or whatever, I mean, to just show some support in this social environment. And I love to have that behind me and give me some more support, that these Facebook lives are appreciated. I love them very much. I get more and more comfortable. And thank you so much for being here today, and talk to you later. Bye-bye.